tributes that seeks to award Brazilian genres and characters. Prelude number one, an homage to the sertanejo, the man from the Brazilian hinterlands. It evokes aspects of the popular genre called modinha. If the first is a lyric melody expressed by the modinha, the second is a choro. Both are Brazilian genres which came out of Rio de Janeiro in the early 20th century, a social cultural scene in which the composer has taken part in his formative years. Prelude number three, made in two sections, the first impressionistic and dramatic, the second a noticeable construct over Johann Sebastian Bach, a major influence throughout Villa-Lobos' work, to whom he dedicated a number of compositions entitled Bachianas Brasileiras. In this piece, marked by tempo fluctuation, extensive use of descending sequences and metric shifts, Villa-Lobos used Baroque elements tempered with a distinguished, relaxed Brazilian flair. Enigmatic of the five known preludes, Villa-Lobos' take on native peoples from the rainforest is hard to trace in its origin. The simplest prelude, which the whole piece based on a melody originated from the opening arpeggio, with a frenetic section across the entire fretboard of the guitar that suggests a multitude of bare feet over the clay of the indigenous village. Prelude number five, homage to social life dedicated to the young teenagers who frequent Rio's concerts and theaters. This is the last prelude, and it's a nostalgic homage to the atmosphere of the 20th century, the early 20th century. We should also mention André Segovia here, the Spanish iconic guitar player who grew close to Villa-Lobos during his exile in Latin America. Segovia moved to Montevideo in the end of the 1930s, fleeing Europe to escape the Spanish Civil War. Segovia encouraged Villa to revisit the guitar in 1940, the year of this composition. The preludes are in a way the result of this encounter. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.